the burros, we haven't had any problems as far as them being nervous. They just seem like go on and stand there just like they would in a horse trailer. Oh, so it's been
watched them pull away with that in the boat. Burros were just along for the ride.
A lot of this that we're dealing with, you know, the grasses are not here naturally, mm-hmm. which the burros, they do fine on the mm-hmm. on the shrubs. But with I guess the best way to put it is that in southern Nevada, it's not that we're in a drought, because we're always in a drought, right. just with the amount of precip that we get. And then the fact that we've had so many animals out here, and our fires have affected this in the last couple mm-hmm. years, which is new for us.
I think it, some of it is the mystique.
Yeah,
you know, the people want to see them out running free, but they don't realize the issues of overpopulation. There's only so much to eat, and wildlife are managed in a way where they issue, you know, hunting tags to take care of excess.
Right.
And livestock can be pulled off and on.
It's and a little more difficult with the horses and burros. Our population, if it would have doubled, we don't have the vegetation right. to support them.
You don't want an emergency. You try and get it to before there's an emergency. But if you know it's imminent, mm-hmm. if it keeps going this way, you will have death. Then that's what she does, is gets in and gathers the animals before they get to a point of maybe dying. And the public just doesn't seem to understand sometimes. They see these animals come in and they look healthy to them, or they see them after BLM has fed them and gotten them back to health again, and they just like seeing them out running free.
Of course, even as BLM employees, we see some that we, mm-hmm. you know, are particularly attached to or like that one. And even if it's one you choose to turn out, you're like, was that the right decision? Could have been gone right. to a better home? Would have been adopted in a heartbeat and someone given it a better home than it has right. on the range? So, well, you know, we experience that as well, just like members of the public. And so everyone's asking for the burros, and uh-huh. it's a high demand. And we've seen that with our burros. We'll have some come back to Las Vegas mm-hmm. for our June adoption. And so we're trying to get them into homes as right. quick as we can. And it seems to have been working fairly good for us.
But if people didn't, if they were shooing them away and keeping them out of town, like around Reno too and here, then the horses would be wild and stay out and not be forced to be gathered. Mm-hmm. But when they start coming in, and if BLM receives one complaint and the horses are out of a herd area, they have to gather them.
Yeah.
They're mandated by law. And then the public gets upset, don't come touch them, they're our backyard pets. And
right.
So BLM is in a tough spot.
So, yeah, it seems like we're in a tough spot a lot of the time.